Hello, this is Josh from WA Production, and today I'm going to walk you through the basics of an important type of tool in audio production, the audio plugin. As a beginner delving into the world of music or audio production, the native effects and instruments found in your digital audio workstation, or DAW, likely were more than enough to satiate your growing knowledge and curiosity. For reference, some popular DAWs include FL Studio, Ableton Live, Logic Pro, Pro Tools, and Cubase. But there are many others. However, at a certain point in the progression of most producers, they want to break free of the constraints of what is offered inside their DAW and do more with the knowledge they have. That is where third-party audio plugins come in. An audio plugin is essentially an application inside of another application, in this case, your DAW. While some plugins can also be operated in standalone mode, meaning outside of a DAW, most cannot and must be run inside of your DAW. Audio plugins typically represent one of three categories: instruments, audio effects, and MIDI effects. Instrument plugins are generally any third-party plugin that generates sound. Popular examples include X-First Serum, Lennar Digital's Silent One, or WA Productions' Babylon. Audio effect plugins are devices that affect and alter a sound in your DAW, and some popular examples of these include X-First OTT, Isotope's Ozone plugins, and WA Productions' Cashmere Essentials. And finally, MIDI effects are plugins that generate MIDI, or Musical Instrument Digital Interface, information. MIDI is basically the communication that tells a device how to behave, examples being which notes to play, a pattern to move a certain parameter by, etc. Some popular examples include Cable Guy's MIDI Shaper and WA Productions' InstaSeries plugins. Okay. I know that was a lot of information to take in, but once you start playing with audio plugins, you'll understand their benefits. There are certain things that plugins enable you to do, and certain sounds that they can help you create that simply wouldn't be possible using your DAW's native tools. For example, Isotope's RX series of plugins are the industry standard for audio restoration and cleanup, and Solemony's Melodyne is the industry standard for tuning vocals. In the opinion of most professionals, no DAW's native tools are nearly as effective for these purposes as these third-party audio effect plugins are. Now, you're probably wondering how to acquire and install plugins so you can use them in your own productions. Let's go through some examples and I'll explain the process for you. First, you'll need to acquire a plugin from somewhere. Most professional quality plugins require a purchase. However, there are many high-quality plugins available for free as well. For example, we have an entire page devoted to free plugins on WA Productions' website, which would be a good place to start. I highly suggest that you make sure to read the system requirements for the plugin before making any purchase. These usually will be featured directly on the plugin's product page. This is essential because if you purchase a plugin that is not supported on your system, it likely will not work properly for you or may not work at all. If you're unsure whether a plugin will work for you or whether you'll like it, it's always a good idea to try the free demo first, which many developers provide. However, you still need to be sure to read the system requirements, even if the demo appears to work on your system. Once you've made your purchase or redeemed your order for a free plugin, you'll need to download the installer. I will note here that every plugin developer has a bit of a different process, but once you've installed plugins from a few different places, you'll get a hang of the basics. Some developers offer a centralized application where you can download all their plugins from and manage licenses and updates within it, while others require you to download each individual plugin from their website. Fortunately, most developers provide very clear instructions immediately after you make your purchase, so be sure to look out for those and read them thoroughly. For WA Production plugins, you'll need to visit your account profile. If you purchased a plugin directly from WA Production's website, your plugins should already be found here under My Orders. If you purchased it elsewhere, you should have received a redemption code and instructions for redeeming it. You'll need to follow those instructions in order for your download and license to appear in your account. Please note that in some cases, as with purchases from our partner Humble Bundle, you'll be provided with both the product installers and license keys in your account on their website, meaning you do not need to create an account on waproduction.com. You can use these keys to activate your plugins directly and manage them via our partner's site. But if you would like to manage your licenses in your WA Production account, you can also add them there by clicking Register Product and entering your key. Please refer to the instructions that came with your order so that you know which process to follow in your specific circumstance. Once you've added the plugin to your account, you'll click on the order, then click download files. If there are multiple options here, be sure to download the installer that corresponds with your operating system. If there are any separate files, like instructions, be sure to download those also. Again, the process for downloading these items will likely differ with other developers. Once you have downloaded the file, you will need to unzip the contents. On Mac, you just need to double-click the zip file. While on PC, you'll have to right-click, then select Extract All. Once you have done this, the first thing you should do is read the instructions. There will likely be a file in your download titled something like Setup Instructions, How to Install, Installation Guide, Quick Start Guide, or Manual. It is super important that you read this before you start, as every plugin will require different steps to install properly. If the file you open is the product manual, find the section that discusses installation. Next, follow the steps to install the plugin. Sometimes this will be as easy as opening the correct installer for your operating system and following the prompts to install. Other times, it will be slightly more complicated, and you may need to drag certain files and folders to the proper locations on your computer. It is imperative that this is done correctly, otherwise, the plugin simply will not work properly, or your DAW may not be able to open it at all. When installing the plugin, you may be given the option of whether to install the VST, or VST2, VST3, AU, or AAX versions of the plugins. It is perfectly safe to install all versions on your device. However, if you'd like to save space or reduce clutter, you likely do not need all of them. If you are using Pro Tools as your DAW, then you will only need the AAX version. However, if you are not using Pro Tools and do not plan to, then you do not need AAX. Audio units, or AU, will only appear on Macs. However, if you are using Logic Pro or GarageBand, AU is essential, as that is the only format they use. However, if you are using other DAWs, it is still usually a good idea to install the AU version, as most other DAWs are compatible with AU as well. Regarding VST, or VST2 more specifically, and VST3, unless you are only using Logic Pro or GarageBand and have no plans to use other DAWs, I suggest you always install these formats. VST and VST3 are generally the standard formats for plugins. It is helpful to try using VST or VST3 wherever possible, because that way, you can open your projects on both Windows and macOS without problems. Having multiple versions of plugins on your computer also helps, as sometimes there may be a glitch or issue with one version on your device that is not present in another version. Once you have completed the installation, you're almost to the finish line, but not quite. Check your installation instructions again. Some plugins may require you to restart your computer. Others may not. Once you have finished following the instructions, you'll need to open your DAW of choice. Some DAWs, like Ableton Live and Logic Pro, will run a plugin scan immediately upon opening. Others, like FL Studio, require you to manually scan for plugins. Either way, ensure your DAW has completed scanning for new plugins. You can do a quick Google search for how to scan for plugins in and insert your DAW name to make sure you are doing this correctly. Once your DAW has finished scanning for plugins, your new plugin should appear. This is another area where every DAW is different. The location where your plugins can be found should be pretty clear, but if you can't see it, that's another thing you can use your friend Google for. Some DAWs, like FL Studio and Logic, will separate plugins by their type. So instruments, also called generators, will be kept separate from audio effects, which are also separate from MIDI effects, and so on. Other DAWs, like Ableton Live, put all your plugins together in one place. Now, you'll need to visit the location where your plugins are listed in your DAW, and either use the search or scroll to find your new plugin. If this is your first plugin, it should be quite easy. Please note that depending on the version of the plugin, sometimes they'll be organized into folders by the developer's name, and other times they'll just be all in one place, sorted by the name of the plugin. If you're not seeing it, check the settings for your DAW to make sure the proper options are enabled. For example, in Ableton, some of these settings may be off by default. Plugins are generally placed in a couple of default locations on your computer, unless you manually change where they're installed. So, using Ableton as an example, you'll want to turn on the settings for Use Plugin System Folders so that Ableton scans the default system locations for your plugins. If you're on Mac, you can also turn on Use Audio Units so that your AU versions appear as well. If you're having any trouble getting your plugins to be scanned, I suggest referring to the manual for your DAW or searching online for answers to your questions. And voila, now you have found your plugin in your DAW. How to add the plugin to your project may vary slightly from DAW to DAW. In most DAWs, there are multiple ways to load a plugin. Also in most DAWs, you can simply drag the plugin onto the track you wish to use it on, or double-click to load it on your currently selected track. In other DAWs, like Logic, you need to click on the location where you would like to load the plugin and select the plugin you wish to add from the tree. In an FL Studio, where playlist tracks can be kept separate from mixer tracks, you'll need to add instrument plugins in the channel rack and effect plugins in the mixer. Once you've opened the plugin, most developers require you to activate or authorize your license to unlock all features or remove a time limit. For WA Production, the limitation found in most of our demo plugins is that it will play a brief white noise every 30 seconds. And in order to remove that, you need to activate the plugin using your license. This extra step is to prevent piracy and unauthorized sharing of the software. Again, each developer's process for this is different. Some will require you to download a license file from your account and load it, and others may even require you to have a physical device like an iLock that stores your license information. For WA Production plugins, you simply need to copy the serial key from your My Product Keys section and paste or type it on the activation screen. Each plugin may be slightly different, and you can find instructions for activating your plugin in our online help center or in the plugin manual. Please note that most developers impose a limit on how many devices may be activated at a time using a single license. WA Production, for example, allows you to use a single license on up to 3 devices. Now, you can play with your plugins to your heart's delight. I highly recommend reviewing the product manual in detail for your plugin before diving in too deeply, though. Some plugins, especially MIDI plugins, require further setup within your DAW. This is because MIDI plugins only generate information, but they do not generate sound. They need to be told where to send this information, such as which instrument to send the notes to, and the process for setting this up is different in every DAW. Your MIDI plugin should have come with detailed instructions for setting this up properly in most major DAWs. Additionally, even more straightforward plugins, like synths and effects, can have a multitude of options and parameters, and may be difficult to grasp at first. Reading the manual should help you a lot, and there likely are many tutorials available online as well. I recommend reviewing the information and videos that are available directly from the developer of the plugin first, so that you make sure you are getting the most accurate information. Finally, one more suggestion is that you make sure to keep your plugins up to date as much as possible. Some plugins from certain developers will prompt you if your plugin version is outdated. Others will not, so it's important to check from time to time if there's a newer version available. If you ever run into issues with your plugins not working properly, the first step is to make sure that you have the most up-to-date version. Oftentimes, when Apple or Microsoft release a new version of their operating system, or when a new version of a DAW is released, this will break something within the plugin and require an update from the plugin developer. So keeping an eye on whether your plugin is up-to-date is usually the best way to ensure that you don't run into any problems opening projects or using your plugins. You now should have a better understanding of what audio plugins are, why they are useful, and how to get started with them. I hope this video has been helpful, and wish you the greatest success in your music and audio production endeavors.